1. Microjob. A microjob is usually a small online task for which you receive an equally small fee, usually a few cents or dollars. They are sometimes called short tasks. These jobs are done by logging on to a company's website and selecting tasks, sometimes simply by clicking a link. Amazon's Mechanical Turk, Clickworker, and Ysense offer these types of tasks. Jobs may also be found in online service marketplaces. Here workers offer small services, usually for a set fee, and buyers browse the marketplace to find people offering the services they need. Job opportunities include crowdsourcing projects, which are similar to data entry, where companies engage an army of virtual workers to perform a small part of a larger project. Workers can also take advantage of reward programs and surveys, which are perhaps the original work-at-home microjobs. 2. Online juror. Attorneys preparing for trial often create a mock jury to obtain feedback from individuals similar to those who may eventually sit on a jury. Because it can be costly to have an in-person mock jury, cheaper online jurors are the logical alternative. They might listen to audio and view video presentations, or read the material and answer questions. Because lawyers are seeking people who match the profile of potential real-life jurors, online jury companies ask detailed questions of applicants. Note that you should never disclose your social security number or credit card or bank information. Companies typically pay $10 to $60 to online jurors. As most online jury companies won't need a lot of jurors, signing up for multiple companies gives you a better chance of getting picked for jury duty. 3. Website or application testing. If you have opinions on what works and what doesn't on the web, you might be suited for a job in remote usability testing. User testers can also pick up additional work reviewing websites or mobile applications that may still be in development. You don't have to be very knowledgeable about the internet because some developers want a beginner's viewpoint. Usability testers are asked to perform tests based on their demographic profiles, such as education, web knowledge, age, and social media use. They are then given questions to address or tasks to perform, such as registering on a website and then providing feedback online. A review usually takes about 15 to 20 minutes and earns typically about $10. After completing a review, testers are not paid until the client accepts their feedback. Work can be rejected and unpaid for technical problems, lack of detail, or other issues the client determines.